Hey guys, welcome back on my channel. Guys, I'm Ramkir Singh, and in today's video we are going to add one more video in the playlist of debug. Guys, in today's video I'm going to share you a very important plugin that will help you to debug your application in your phone, in your PC. Guys, in the previous time when we have to debug our application in the Android mode, in the Android phone and in the PC. So what we were doing is that if we are working on the Android, so we used to Android Studio. But guys, I'm sharing a plugin that will help you to debug your application in your Android phone. So if you're new on the channel, make sure you subscribe the channel. And guys, if you want to ask something, so drop the question in the comment box. So let's start the tutorial video. Hello friends, welcome back on National Mango channel. Guys, right now I am in Unity, and what I am going to do today is that I am going to tell you a plugin that will help you to debug your application. So let's start the today video. If you are new on the channel, make sure subscribe the channel. If you want to ask something, drop your comment below. So guys, this is my Unity project I have taken. You can take anyone. And guys, I have taken one script, that is the Unity debug. You know very well I am running one playlist, that is the Unity debugger, in which I am telling you how you can debug your game, how you can debug your application. So guys, let's open in the Unity debug. So just here you will see, here is my script. So first of all, I'm going to write few debug line, like this is debug.log, and what we will do is that we are writing the debug lines many places in many methods, and we will debug without using the your console window. I will tell you one plugin that will help you. So let's do it. Debug.log, and here we are in Awake. This is our start. Here I am doing debug.log. Start. Okay. And guys, few people was commented that how you can color it. So I was told you, and if you don't know, so you can just visit my playlist and you will know there is one playlist, that is the debug playlist, debug.log. Guys, when we are working on the very large scale project, so we just use any symbol so that we can get our logs. We also use color. So here is all void start application, and let's use one more thing, that is the void update, let update. Really not matter in which method I am writing. I am just writing debug.log. Why? Because I want to track using my plugin, not the console, so that I can get the this debug message so that I can show you. Okay, so these are the messages. Let's back on Unity. And guys, here is my asset. So just go on search log viewer.
here is log viewer. After searching it, you will get this. Let's download it. After downloading, you have to import. And here you will get a bunch of data and scripts. So let's import it. Guys, it will be work in your window application, in your mobile application, so it will help you a lot. So just wait for a few seconds and you will see here is tab and here is generated reporter. When you will import it, so here is the tabs, component, UI, GUI, and here you can see also reporter. Okay, so let's back to scene, and now we have to go on reporter and we have to just click on that, and here you have to create. So few people ask me that if my game is so big, so what I have to do, I have to place on every scene the reporter game object. So no, you have not to do it. Just you have to use the one scene and where you have to place the reporter, and make sure that scene is not destroyable. So you have placed the reporter. Here is the script, so you don't have to do anything, it's already done. So what you have to do is now you have to play. So you can see on the console we are able to see these things. So what I have to do now, is that you have to take your mouse and you have to just take your mouse on the game scene and you have to just rotate your mouse on the screen. Now you will able to see, you can see you are able to see the logs on the screen, and if you want to click, you can want to clean, so you can clean it, but you can see that late update is so many, so we are not able to see the others. Here you will get so many things, you can observe so many things, what the processing is going on, you can see there. So there are so many parameters you can observe from here. You can back from here and then you can click here, but let's remove the late update because it's really creating lots of, so we are not able to see other. So you can see how what I am doing to generate the log viewer on the screen. So just I am showing on my mouse, just rotating on the screen, on the gameplay screen. I'm doing again. Suppose you want to remove it, so how you can do it? Suppose you have generated on the screen, and so how you can close it? So you can see there is a on stand and log, it really not matter, but there is a one cross button. So when you click on it, so it will remove. And if you want to again generate, so just move your mouse on the screen, it will generate. Okay, now you can see there is on application focus, on application when I'm clicking here, so it is on application focus, it's running. So you can see there is a console working, and here is also our console. When I'm going there, so on application focus is working. Okay, and it will work on every places. So hope you got the idea and you learn, enjoy the video. If you want to ask, so you can drop the comment below in the comment box.
Guys, this debugging method will help you in your phone, in your PC. So hope you enjoy the video, and guys, this video will help you to find out your errors, your bug. So thank you so much for watching. Have a good day. Keep learning, keep growing, and make sure drop a beautiful comment below. Or guys, if you want to check out my blogging channel, so you can check out Ramkes Mr. RK blog. And if you want to follow me on the Instagram, you can connect me RamkesCC084. So thanks so much for watching. Have a good day. Keep learning, keep growing.